Welcome back to the channel. I want to show you guys this Dustbuster tool. As I was examining this shot here, when we make our way to the last frame, this is typical of stuff shot on film. Right here we have what's called a splice and a printer flash. So when they join the two pieces of film together right here, this is a little, maybe a piece of glue or some dirt that got left. And they usually clean that up in post-production. This is an older version, and this is a DVD version instead of a Blu-ray. So it has some of these defects here. I went ahead and grabbed this Dustbuster tool from the effects, and I made a new parallel node. And if we have the view with the patch off, you can see how it cleans that up. Sort of a haloing here. Let's see how this tool works. So I'll go ahead and reset it. Just grab Dustbuster, threw it on. So it's parallel, so it's bypassing the lighting effects that we're doing on the last video. If you guys watched that, I added some glow into these lights here, which look like that, just to kind of give it a little bit of a different look, and did some tracking, things like that. So as I was cruising around on these sequence just looking for stuff, I noticed this problem here. Normally, you'd have to go to some kind of external editor. We had a department where I worked. That post-production company had its own like dirt removal team, and they had some specialized equipment to do that. But here, we'll just show you how to do this in the box. So the Dustbuster has a couple of options here. We have an ellipse or a rectangle, and you can kind of just draw it much like the patch replacer, and it starts taking some surrounding information here. And as you can see, it does a pretty smooth job. So depending on where you angle this, you're gonna have to watch your output monitor. And it seems like if you go a little bit wider, so this is now on a single frame. I didn't really do any other adjustments. I did soften the edge just a hair, so you can just watch your output and just kind of look where this line is meeting across your, you know, untouched image. And it's essentially a one frame fix. So if we look at the full output, go to the end of the shot here, see if we can go full screen on it. That's the kind of shift I'm seeing on my output monitor. There's some video noise, some dirt. So let's see if we can smooth that out based on what the tool looks like here. So we can bring the size down. I think the soft edge is really what's going to sell it. And then maybe a global blend. We also have UI line thickness. So we could bring this down a little bit if we were trying to see what's underneath. And then output, we have patch locations. Kind of shows you the key, the differences. So right here, you can see what it's kind of interpolating. Let's go back to patched result and then maybe bring this global blend down just a notch. And that actually, you can see this film stain here. There might be a better paint approach since it's a single frame. You might paint that out. Let's stick with this tool and see what else we can make it look like. So we have clone options, plus and minus a frame. So we actually would probably want to clone the frame prior. So if we hit clone and then go here and say blend, I think auto pretty much does that where it's taking information from the previous frame, but we still have all that noise. Let me go over to here so we can look. So it might need a noise reduction on top of this. Yeah, it might just need to be bigger. That looks a little cleaner. There's still a little bit of a arc going here. There's some noise in the street. So maybe a little bit of noise reduction. Let's try that on the same node. Although, I mean, it does look cleaner in this patch. There's some throughout here. So let's grab maybe one more parallel node here. And that's option P. And the reason I use parallel is so you don't use serial where things are stacking on top of one another. Think of it as taking a clean copy out to this node and then combining it here. And then you get this last, you know, like this has the glow on it. This has the window. This has the patch. So let's do noise reduction here, which is found down here. And there's a few different versions. There's Ultra, which is a studio version, but for now, we'll just go fast. We have the Lumina and Chrominance linked. You can always deselect these to choose different options. You can see how drastic that changes the picture, but softening it quite a bit. And another tip is the three-dot menu here, and you can actually show your split colors. So instead of looking at RGB, we could be looking at just the red channel. We can look at just the green. And a lot of times, some of these other channels have more noise in it by itself. So if you wanted to isolate that, you could within a node isolate it to just one of the other channels, like using with the custom curves here, D-Link, and say you want to isolate a blue channel only, maybe do a little bit of drop down if you're trying to get rid of some noise. So I got a little bit going here. I might do a little temporal noise reduction. It works kind of similarly. You will get some softening of your image. There are some third-party ones that work quite well, but you do have to pay for those. So let's go on and off and let's see. That's not doing a whole lot to my eye. So we might need a little more. Let's go too much and then pull it back. Looks like the luma really is where the noise is. So I'm gonna do, instead of dragging this slider here, I'm gonna drag inside this box with the option key, and that lets you dial it in by point instead of just a slider value. And that works for all your slider boxes. So that's a little bit of noise reduction there, not too much. But let's look if we go back a couple frames. So we can still see a little bit of flash. Maybe we can pull the patch out a little bit bigger. So let's put on show patch one more time, and we'll go to our open effects overlay. I'll shrink this down. Let's maybe raise this up just a bit and get it more in line with this car's tire here. And then go back, and then let's zoom this in. Try to pay more attention to where that patch lives. That's a little more acceptable. So other than this little corner here, that cleaned that up quite a bit. I would probably apply a little bit more noise reduction, but as you can see, we got quite a bit. I mean, look at this car in the next shot here. So that's how you use the Dustbuster and a little bit of noise reduction comped inside without affecting these two other parallel nodes with the lights and the glow effect. All right, thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys on the next video.